All right, it is time to get started with our cute little planter inspired by one of my favorite little snacks, bubble tea. So you're just going to make sure that your planter is clear of debris. It might have some styrofoam on it. And then you just get painting. So you'll see that the paint goes on kind of streaky. So what you'll need to do is a couple of coats. You can let it dry for a few minutes. It is acrylic. It dries pretty quickly. And then you'll do a couple of coats. You don't need to paint the inside because you are going to probably use this to plant something in. You could also use it as a pencil holder or a knickknack holder. That's okay. Then maybe you want to paint the inside. But I'm going to do a couple of coats. I'm not going to show it because that's not so exciting. But all of these streaks and the unevenness that we're seeing will eventually go away with a couple of coats. You can see I'm using a foam brush for this. I also have a thin tipped brush that we'll use to make the face. And I have some clear school glue that we use for those little half beads that you see on the left side of my screen. Those are our Boba pearls. So once this is dry and I'm satisfied with the coverage on the pot, I forgot to film myself gluing the pearls on. So my glue was very, very runny, so my pearls kind of slid everywhere, but you can use a regular white school glue and glue your pearls on. You might need to do it kind of slowly and hold them in place because as I spun mine around, they started to slide. But now they're all dry and I'm ready to work on the face. Which, like I said, I forgot to film, so I'm going back and I'm doing it on a different day. But that's okay. So we're gonna start with the thin brush and the black paint. I like to get the tip of my brush a little bit wet in some water because it makes the paint glide smoother. So I'm starting with the eyes, which is just a circle, and I'm just pushing the brush and kind of swiveling around. I'm not actually actively trying to draw a circle. I'm just letting the brush do the work by swiveling it around. And then you can watch me try to make it even and actually a circle and not a blob. Good luck, symmetry and circles are not my strong point, but that's okay. This does not need to be perfect. Our crafts are perfectly imperfect and we like them just like that. Okay, so it's time to do the second eye. So again, you'll see I just press the tip of the brush down and I kind of swivel and I let this long, thin tip do its own thing rather than try to draw a circle. And then I just fill it in and make sure my black paint is all nice and even. So the next thing I'm going to do is the cute little mouth. Again, make sure that there's a little bit of water on the tip of your brush so that your paint flows nice and easy. And this little mouth I'm kind of doing off to the side. It's kind of a jaunty little smirky kind of character. So I just do a line on top and then two lines down, almost like a triangle, but I don't complete it. And then a little swoop to make the bottom of the mouth round, and then I fill it in. And then here I am speeding this up, trying to make the mouth a little more even and get rid of some brush strokes. It's okay, it doesn't need to be perfect. So to make the little dots in the eyes, the little glint, we use the back of the brush. I dip the back of the brush into the white paint. There's a little bead of paint on there and I lightly just dab it to get a little small circle. See, it's just a light little dab, and then for the bigger one, I press down a little bit harder with what's left on the back of my brush. Okay, so we'll do that again. I'll show you again, just a little tap. And then I press down more firmly for a big dot. And that's that. Okay, so now I'm gonna clean off the back of my brush and mix some light pink paint with my white and my magenta. And then I'm going to use this to create the cute little blushy cheeks, which is just a line right underneath both eyes. Just a cute little blushing boba planter. Eventually, I decided that I did not like the color of this pink, so you'll see me mixing up a little bit darker in a little bit. And then again, you can just kind of play with your shape, make sure it's exactly the way that you like it. Perfectly imperfect, there's no right way. Okay, so here you can see I'm making it a little bit darker. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do the mouth. Do you see what I see? It is still wet. This is my mistake. I try to paint the little tongue in there and oops, there goes the black. So I wait for about 2 minutes for it to dry. I go in with my darker pink and I fix the tongue and I fix the little blushy cheeks as well. Okay, so as you can see, remember I said that my glue was kind of sliding all around with my beads? I was using kind of a really loose glue. So I'll bring it back up and you can see all of those shiny marks where the boba was sliding around while it was drying. If this happens to you, now that everything's dry, you can go back in with your pink color and touch it back up and it'll cover those little shiny glue spots. See? Not super pretty, but also I don't really mind it that much. It's fine. You can do whatever you need to do, but hopefully you're using a glue that's a little thicker than mine was. And that's it. That's your little bubble tea inspired planter. Fill it with dirt, plant some seeds, and see what happens.